Hi, I'm Matt, the in-house metalheadologist here at Red Pepper. And welcome to Touch on Tech, where we get smart on the latest tech so we can share it with you. Would you like to rock on with us? So Spot's on the loose, Boston Dynamics' little robot dog, except he's not too far on the loose because he's in an art gallery with a paintball gun attached to him that you can control from your phone anywhere in the world. Mischief has turned Spot into an art piece that you can decorate an entire art exhibit with from the comfort of your own home. Just grab your phone and drive Robot Dog all around firing paintballs at everything in sight. It switches out drivers every 2 minutes, so get your place in line and just decorate some art with a paintball gun attached to a Robot Dog. Very safe, don't worry about the future. Everything's gonna be fine.
Pew, pew, pew.
So if you're having issues cooking cookies, you're just burning them all over the place, or I don't know, they come out and they're not even cooked, well, you can contact an AI to fix it for you. Ruth is Nestle Tollhouse's AI chatbot that you can log in and talk to get all the cookie tips you need. You can ask her, hey, why did I burn all these cookies to death? Oh, don't say death. It uses Google Dialogue Flow to create a two-way conversation between you and the bot, and using a technology similar to deepfakes, it creates an avatar for what this cookie AI actually looks like. So you're talking to almost a human. This makes those little chatbot windows a lot more interesting because you can see that there's someone on the other side. It's not just a faceless AI, it's a faceful AI. So when you finally get back to your office, you may want to add a COVID-friendly chatbot to the front lobby so that you can have people come in and say, hi, I'm here to see Matt. And all of a sudden, by a little spot is me, Matt, getting dragged down the stairs. Bom, 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 bom. Here is your Matt. I brought him to you. So NFTs have been hot recently. We talked about them on the last episode, but they've been getting even hotter because the prices for these things are going through the roof. Currently, Beeple's 5,000 days piece is going for over $1 million for a JPEG. And what's fascinating about the NFTs from a rights management standpoint is that whenever one of these NFTs gets resold on the aftermarket, the artist gets a commission from that. So as this thing trades and trades and trades down the years, people's getting tons of money. Just boom, 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 like that. So are you still iffy about touching buttons out of the grocery store when you're running your credit card and like hitting the buttons on the gas pump? Well, a Japanese company has come up with a way to get around touching physical buttons and getting yourself sick. They've created hologram buttons. So you just stick your finger on top of one of these hologram buttons, touch some air, and it'll do the same thing that the physical button would do. And your fingers are totally clean and sparkly. Look at that. COVID-free, germ-free, germ-free for me. So is the future of our interactions going to be us in little rectangles forever? Nope. Not if Samsung has anything to say about it, because they've created some stylish augmented reality glasses that overlay the world with all of the data you would usually have on your computer, but it's in 3D. So instead of someone being in a little Zoom rectangle, they're actually a full hologram, and you get to talk to them like they're standing in the room with you. So you can imagine talking to a cookie AI in your augmented reality glasses, standing right next to your oven, pointing at your burnt cookies saying, see, that one's burnt and that one's burnt, but I know how to fix them for you. Thanks, Cookie AI. Well, that's it for another edition of Touch on Tech. Thanks for stopping by and spending some time with us, and we hope to see you next time on another edition of Touch on Tech.